Hi everyone, welcome back to this series called Finance Current Affairs. In this very series, we pick up some important financial topics and we try and discuss them with the help of different questions. Before I start with first question, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe and hit the notification bell. If you want to watch the Finance Current Affairs sessions for the past entire year, then we have the RBI 247 playlist created on our channel. You can watch the previous pre-finance current affair sessions as well. Now talking about the free PDF of this very session. So if you want the free PDF, please join our Telegram group. Link is in the description below. We provide all the free PDFs of these sessions on Telegram group only. Now let's come to first question that says, what does it refer to? So yahan pe do statements hai and we have to identify the concept which is being discussed over here. एक एक करके इन स्टेटमेंट्स को देख लेते हैं. फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट सेज इट इज अ सॉल्यूशन फॉर एनबीएफसीज व्हिच इज एकन टू द कोर बैंकिंग सॉल्यूशंस अडॉप्टेड बाय बैंक्स. सो बैंक्स एक सिस्टम फॉलो करते हैं, एक कोर बैंकिंग सॉल्यूशन फॉलो करते हैं एंड सिमिलर टू दैट अ न्यू सॉल्यूशन हैज बीन सजेस्टेड फॉर एनबीएफसीज एज वेल व्हिच दे हैव टू अडियर टू. द सेकंड स्टेटमेंट सेज इट हैज बीन मेड मैंडेटरी बाय आरबीआई to be adhered by NBFC's middle layer and upper layer which have 10 or more fixed point service delivery units. So this very system which is similar to the core banking solution of bank has been made mandatory for certain category of NBFCs. So let us discuss in detail about this core banking solution, about this fixed point service delivery units. A notification has come out from RBI's end that relates to all of this. Okay, so for your information, the answer to this question is option A, CFSS. Ab hum dekhte hain ki ye CFSS ka full form kya hai, CFSS kya hai, ye core banking solution se kaise related hai, and let's discuss some more concepts in the upcoming slides. So first of all, CFSS stands for Core Financial Services Solution. So RBI ने last year एक circular निकाला था that relates to NBFCs and that very circular came up with a revised scale-based regulation framework for NBFCs. So there was a pyramid where it was specified that the NBFCs have been divided into four different categories in the base layer, middle layer, top layer, upper layer. Okay, so if you want to understand that scale-based regulation framework of NBFCs, you can go and watch that session. We have the PDF uploaded related to that in the course as well. So October day 10 session is when I covered that framework. Okay, it's also there in the form of PDF for the enrolled students. So वहाँ पे properly discuss किया कि कौन सी ये four categories है. There are certain middle layer NBFCs, upper layer. So you can understand what types of NBFCs are classified in those categories. So when that very circular came up in October, it was mentioned over there that NBFCs with 10 or more branches will adopt the core banking solution and a 3-year path was given for the same starting 1st October 2022. So उसी circular में ये बोल दिया गया था कि core banking solution जैसा solution कुछ NBFCs को अब implement करना होगा within a span of 3 years starting from 1st October 2022. There it was also mentioned that RBI will come up with another circular in this regard. So अब वो नया circular या वो नई notification आ गई है. उस अब जो notification आई है उसमें क्या mention है? The recent notification says that RBI has decided that NBFCs middle layer and NBFCs upper layer. So middle layer NBFCs are those all the deposit taking NBFCs irrespective of their asset size. Then agar hum baat kare non deposit taking NBFCs ki, so ones which are having more than 1000 crore worth of asset size, they are classified under the NBFCs middle layer. Iske alawa aur activities ke basis pe bhi NBFCs kuch hai jo middle layer mein aayengi. So this is the NBFC middle layer. NBFC upper layer mein top 10 asset size ke base mein NBFCs aa jati hain which have more enhanced regulatory requirements. So that is covered in the next slide as well. In dono NBFCs mein agar 10 or more fixed point service delivery units hai, aage hum discuss karenge ye kya hote hain. If these NBFCs have more than or 10 or more than 10 fixed point service delivery units as on 1st October 2022, then they need to mandatorily implement this core financial service solution, which is similar to the core banking solution which the banks accept. So in two categories of NBFCs, if there are 10 or more fixed point delivery units, then they need to implement this system, core financial service solution. Now let's discuss these terms which have been used over here. So this is the slide that covers the middle layer and the upper layer NBFCs, which types of NBFCs are covered over here. This October ke session mein already covered hai detail mein, so you can watch that session. Now talking about the core banking solution. But before that, there was a term used, fixed point service delivery units. So fixed point service delivery units, agar 10 ya usse zyada hain, to ye system implement karna hai. What are fixed point service delivery units? These NBFCs are providing the financial intermediation. So the place through which these activities are carried out, they are fixed point service delivery units. Jo places hain jahan se ye sari business activity financial intermediation ki NBFCs ke end pe hoti hain, be it through their own staff, be it through outsourced agents, wo hote hain fixed point service delivery units, jahan se ye sara financial intermediation ka business ho raha hai. लेकिन अगर कोई एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिस है, बैक ऑफिस, बैक एंड ऑफिस है, जहां से कस्टमर्स के साथ डायरेक्ट इंटरफेस नहीं है, देन दे विल नॉट बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस फिक्स पॉइंट सर्विस डिलीवरी यूनिट. सो जब ये काउंटिंग करेंगे तो एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिस और बैक ऑफिस जहां पे कस्टमर के साथ डायरेक्ट इंटरफेस नहीं है, वो काउंट नहीं किए जाएंगे. सो दिस वॉज अ टर्म यूज, सो आई वॉन्टेड टू डिफाइन इट फॉर यू ऑल. अब बात करते हैं कोर बैंकिंग सॉल्यूशन की, रिलेटेड टू विच अ CFSA सिस्टम इज सजेस्टेड फॉर NBFCs. Now suppose I open an account with one of the branches of SBI, say located in the university area, and I want to access my account or do some transaction with that account from some other branch in Delhi of the same bank, say SBI. मैंने account university area वाले branch में खोला, there I provided all the physical documents and all required, but I can also get the transactions done through other branches. Moreover, there are various online platforms existing, digital platforms, and we can do that online banking as well. Now, there is some system, some kind of a software, which is linking all these things together, which is maintaining our database on the servers. So that system is the core banking solution system. एक तरह से ये एक नेटवर्क ऑफ ब्रांचेस है जो बैंक की अलग अलग ब्रांचेस को टुगेदर कनेक्ट कर रहा है, विच इज मेंटेनिंग द डेटाबेस ऑफ द कस्टमर्स, थ्रू विच द कस्टमर्स आर एबल टू एक्सेस देयर अकाउंट्स फ्रॉम एनी ब्रांच रिगार्डलेस ऑफ वेयर दे आर मेंटेनिंग देयर अकाउंट. मोर ओवर दे आर एबल टू एक्सेस द सर्विसेज नॉट ओनली फिजिकली बट थ्रू द ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म्स एज वेल 24/7. सो ये पूरा सिस्टम जो ये फैसिलिटेट करता है उसको हम कहते हैं कोर बैंकिंग सॉल्यूशन. Similar to that, now CFSS needs to be implemented by NBFC. So, aisa ek arrangement ab NBFCs ko bhi karna hoga. So, this core financial service solution will create a seamless customer interface in digital offerings, and it will ensure transactions related to product and services with anywhere and anytime facility. So, jo bhi ye services, deposits, की लेंडिंग की और भी बहुत सी सर्विसेज NBFCs देते हैं, ये सब ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म्स के थ्रू इजीली मिलेंगी, एंड एट एनी टाइम एनी वेयर यू कैन गेट दीज सर्विसेज बिकॉज एवरीथिंग विल बी कनेक्टेड टू द कोर सिस्टम. एंड NBFC कैन इंटीग्रेट इट्स डिफरेंट सिस्टम्स टुगेदर, देन अ सेंट्रल डेटाबेस विल बी मेंटेन जहाँ सारी रिकॉर्डिंग होगी. इट विल हेल्प इन बेटर रेगुलेटरी रिपोर्टिंग एज वेल, इट विल हेल्प इम्प्रूव द इंटरनल पर्पसेज एज वेल. सो इसीलिए कोर फाइनेंशियल सर्विस सॉल्यूशन NBFCs के लिए भी सजेस्ट किया गया है. नाउ कमिंग टू द टाइम फ्रेम फॉर इट्स इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, कब तक का टाइम दिया गया है NBFCs को इसको इम्प्लीमेंट करने के लिए. सो फॉर मिडिल लेयर अपर लेयर NBFCs वेयर दे आर हैविंग 10 और मोर फिक्स पॉइंट डिलीवरी यूनिट्स, सो द डेट इज 30th September 2025. इस डेट से पहले पहले इनको ये इम्प्लीमेंट कर देना है. बट देर इज वन मोर रिक्वायरमेंट, दैट अपर लेयर NBFCs, they need to make sure that at least 70% of these fixed points in the service delivery units are implementing this system by 30th September 2024. So, baki sabke liye ye deadline hai, lekin at least 70% jo ye units hai NBFC upper layer ke, unhe ek saal pehle hi ye implement karni hogi. Now, talking about the base layer NBFCs or the NBFCs who are in the middle and the upper layer but have less than 10 fixed point service delivery units. So इनके लिए ये mandatory नहीं है, it's optional for them. If they want, they can implement it for their own benefit. If they don't want, there is no mandate as of now. ठीक है, इसके अलावा in order to check the progress that whether they are working towards the implementation or not, from 31st March 2023 onwards, quarterly, these NBFCs need to report to RBI about their progress on the implementation. Okay. So this was all. And now coming to next question. This is the second question that says, which of the following is the first country? The first country to adopt India's UPI system with the help that will help in transforming the digital economy of that country. So recently, a country ne India ka UPI system ko apni country mein adopt kar liya hai, and that will help in building up the digital economy of that country. So which country am I talking about? The answer is option C, it's Nepal. Let's discuss a bit about this news piece. So Nepal वो पहली country बनी है जो India का UPI system अपनी country में deploy कर रहे हैं, and by deploying the system, they are going to build up their digital economy. So the retail payments umbrella organization in India, the NPCI, उसकी एक international arm है. उसकी international arm का नाम क्या है? Its international arm is NPCI, International Payments Limited, NIPL. So this very international arm has joined the hands with Gateway Payment Services and Manam Infotech, and through their help now this system is going to get implemented in Nepal. So ye jo Gateway Payment System ki hum baat kar rahe hain, this is the authorized payment system operator in Nepal. And Manam Infotech ki baat kare, it's an infotech firm, a financial technology firm which basically helps in implementation of the digital platforms across the countries worldwide. So isne UPI system ko वहां पे डिप्लॉय करने में हेल्प करनी है, एंड ये काफी डिजिटल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस जो वर्ल्ड वाइड हो रहे हैं उसके इम्प्लीमेंटेशन में ऑलरेडी हेल्प करता आ रहा है. फर्दर टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाई द नेपाल हैज एक्सेप्टेड इंडियाज यूपीआई सिस्टम एंड व्हाई एनपीसीआईज इंटरनेशनल आर्म हैज अग्रीड टू शेयर दिस टेक्नोलॉजी विद नेपाल. सो अगर हम बात करें सबसे पहले कि नेपाल को इससे क्या फायदा होने वाला है. सी लाइक आर कंट्रीज बेनिफिटिंग बिकॉज ऑफ द डिजिटल ट्रांजैक्शंस, द नेपाल्स गवर्नमेंट, द नेपाल सेंट्रल बैंक आल्सो हैज अ विजन, सर्टेन ऑब्जेक्टिव्स दैट दे वांट टू क्रिएट अ डिजिटल इकोनॉमी. सो दिस स्टेप इज गोइंग टू हेल्प अ लॉट इन डिजिटाइजिंग देयर कैश ट्रांजैक्शंस. जो वहां पे ज्यादा अभी कैश ट्रांजैक्शंस हो रहे हैं वो डिजिटल प्लेटफॉर्म्स में शिफ्ट हो जाए, ये मेजर ऑब्जेक्टिव है नेपाल का. And that can be fulfilled if they implement this UPI system over there. It will serve the larger digital public good. So, logo ko bhi isse easily convenience milti hai, easily transactions kabhi bhi one click pe wo kar sakte hain. So, that facility will be provided to the public over there. It's beneficial for them. So, larger public good ke liye ye helpful hai. Then, it will make easy the interoperable real-time transactions. So real-time person-to-person transfers karne hai, transactions karni hai, kisi merchant ko payments karni hai, koi cheeze aap khareed rahe ho uske liye person ko, merchant ko payment karni hai. So all that can be done in real-time through UPI. So the immediate payment transfer benefits will arise out of this. If I talk about India, around 39 crore financial transactions which are worth 940 billion US dollars are happening through UPI. Okay, which accounts for a lot of India's GDP. It has helped India a lot. And if Nepal also accepts this, it will help in transforming the digital economy over there. Ek less cash society, ek more digital society build up karega. When these digital transactions are happening, when you can easily real-time payments can be made, then it will give more boost to the businesses. Easily aap payments kar sakte ho business purposes ke liye. Then it's very affordable system. And it will make sure that these financial services reach every nook and corner of that country. So financial inclusion ki taraf ye work karega. These are the benefits for Nepal, jis wajah se they are accepting UPI. Now talking about the NIPL's perspective. See, when your technology is going global, it's actually enhancing your reputation that we have done so good. We have such good technological capabilities. Okay, that we are able to share them globally. NIPL always has an objective that it wants to transform the payment system. And when it can do something for the global markets as well, it can share its payment solution, it can build up its reputation, everything is coming with this very step. Moreover, it also has a way forward that the real-time cross-border payments between India and Nepal can be made easy. So, India and Nepal ke beech koi cross-border payments person-to-person jaani hai, real-time mein wo easily ja sakengi. So, this was all about this news piece. One more thing which I want to mention over here. You might think that once I covered that this NIPL earlier also partnered with some country that also became the first country to accept the UPI. So, wo kya news thi jab wahan pe bhi humne kaha tha ki ye first country bani. So, earlier the news was that Singapore and Bhutan also accepted this UPI, but not for real-time payment system implementation there, only for accepting UPI-based payments. So, India ka koi person wahan jaake UPI ke through payment karna chahata hai, that was allowed. Wahan pe UPI system use karna allow kar diya gaya tha, but that was not related to implementing the UPI system for their nation. Now, this real-time payment system will get implemented in Nepal. That's the difference. Okay. Now, coming to third question. That says, which of the following is correctly related to SEBI Alternative Investment Policy Advisory Committee? So, yahan SEBI ki ek committee ki baat ki ja rahi hai, the Alternate Investment Policy Advisory Committee. This committee has recently been reconstituted. Let's discuss a bit about it, then we'll come back to the question. So, ye SEBI ko advise karne wali ek committee hai. On what matters does it advise SEBI? It advises SEBI on the development of alternate investment fund space. So, alternate investment fund, jo ek unconventional financial asset hai, isse related issues mein, iski development mein, SEBI ko ye wali advisory committee advise karti hai. This committee has recently been reconstituted. So, agar hum baat kare alternate investment fund ki, one is that we have some conventional assets. We have stocks, bonds. But alternative investment fund is basically an unconventional asset. Ye thoda alag hai. Here, the money is pooled from various high net worth individuals, from various sophisticated individuals. And then that money is invested for their benefit. Now, if I mention you some examples, then they include your venture capital fund, private equity fund, hedge fund, angel fund, infrastructure fund. Ye aur zyada risky hai, aur zyada complex hai. The money is actually being provided to various social impact firms or to various startups in order to help them grow, help them emerge as a company. So that's why it's more risky. Now talking about this panel of SEBI, this advisory committee, ये क्या matters पे SEBI को advise करती है, as we discussed on developing this alternate investment industry, and then this industry helps a lot in developing the startups in India. So anything related to development of startups, it also advises on that and any other issues which might arise. Now this committee used to have 22 members, but now currently it is having 20 members. It has been reconstituted, and now the committee has Mr. Narayan Murthy, who was the co-founder of Infosys, as its chairperson. Iske alawa, is committee mein aur jo members hain, they are from SEBI, they are from Ministry of Finance, some are alternative investment fund players, and some also belong to other industry associations. So, you don't need to memorize all the 20 members. I have mentioned it over here for your understanding. Aap dekh sakte ho, yahan pe Mr. Narayan Murthy is the chairperson. Then there are people like Deputy Director of Ministry of Finance on this very board. Then there are people from the SEBI. Executive Director of SEBI is the member. So these are some personalities who are existing on this very board. Okay. Then the Indian Association of Alternate Investment Funds person, its governing council member is also the member of this very committee of SEBI. Now coming back to the question, hume yahan pe correct statement identify karni hai. So first is that this committee advises SEBI on matters related to AIF space, correct. It currently has 22 members, incorrect. Currently 20 members hain. This committee is chaired recently by Mr. Narayan Murthy, it's correct. So A and C hi correct hai, that's why answer is option D. Now coming to last question. Identify the incorrect statements from the options given below. So, ye jo options diye hai, they relate to two topics. One, Department of Financial Services of one of the ministries of government. Second, related to the Central Board of RBI. So let's discuss a bit about that first. What's the recent news regarding that? इसके बाद हम वापस क्वेश्चन पे आएंगे. So recently, Central Government has appointed a director on the Central Board of RBI. So Central Government ने किसको as a director appoint किया है Central Board में recently? श्री संजय मल्होत्रा has recently been appointed effective from 16th February. So he was earlier the secretary of Department of Financial Services which works under Ministry of Finance. So इससे पहले ये Ministry of Finance के एक department में secretary थे. So now I want to discuss two concepts with you. One is the Department of Financial Service, other is the Central Board of RBI. So जहां तक बात आती है Department of Financial Services की, so first question is, it works under which Ministry of Government? So it's the answer is Ministry of Finance. Second question is, what is the role of this very department? So ये department जो है, it oversees various programs, various reforms, various initiatives of the government which relate to your banking, insurance and pension sector in India. So banking, insurance or pension sector से related कोई भी concerns हैं, कोई भी initiatives लेने हैं, कोई भी programs लाने हैं, तो ये ministry जो है उस सबको ministry के अंदर ये department उन सबको oversee करता है. If I talk about the initiatives or reforms towards which this department works, so financial inclusion हो गया, social security हो गया, insurance हो गया, credit flow ensure करना है to the economy, to the farmers, to the common man. So all these are the focus area of this very department. Now coming to the last part, that is the central board. Central board का क्या काम है? So अगर हम central board की बात करें, तो RBI के सारे affairs को ये board govern करता है. RBI's affairs are governed by this board. Okay, the board is appointed by Government of India. Now talking about its constitution, so it has certain official and non-official members. Official full-time members की बात करें, so we have one governor and not more than four deputy governors. So ये main सबसे highest position पे हैं RBI के, right? Then talking about non-official directors, so there are 10 directors from various fields. There are 2 government officials and 4 directors of the local boards. 4 local boards hai jisme se 4 har ek board mein se ek director is central board pe bhi appoint hota hai. What is a local board? Local board basically advises central board on certain matters that relate to territorial or economic interests of some particular local cooperative bank or some indigenous bank. So particularly local region ke banks related matters hain, usme ye both central board ko advise karte hain. So 4 local boards hain, kahan kahan hain? Ek Mumbai mein hai, one is in Kolkata, one is in Chennai and one is in New Delhi. Now coming back to our question, identifying the incorrect statement. So first is that Department of Financial Services is a department under Ministry of Commerce. So yahi galti mil gayi, it's under Ministry of Finance. Second, RBI's affairs are governed by Central Board of Directors, correct. Central Board ke official directors mein ek governor or not more than 4 deputy governors hai, correct. 4 local boards hai in Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai and New Delhi, correct. So only A is incorrect, answer is option A. So here the answer is option A. Okay, so that's it for today. I hope it was useful for you all. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.